Irish are known for their wit and their charm, but our next guest has been crowned Ireland's King of Comedy. Let's take a look at him in action.
Who was the first woman in the world?
The first?
Yes.
Give us a clue.
First woman in the world. Apple.
Granny Smith.
Okay, the third question is, what was Eve's first words to Adam?
That's a hard one.
Correct.
And he joins us live in the studio. Please welcome Brendan Grace, the studio team.
Nice to be here.
Very welcome. Disappointed you didn't wear the outfit.
I know, I was going to, but we couldn't change clothes in the taxi. Just like any other country, when it rains, it does two things. It makes flowers grow and taxis disappear.
Yes. So and your hair funny. Curly too.
Yes, it certainly curly. Does, yeah.
I was, I've been watching your shows all week. You're just so, so funny. And you often wear a tuxedo. You've scrubbed up very nicely.
Yes.
How do you feel? Everyone in Australia, especially around St Patrick's Day and Cup Day, discover that they're all Irish. How do you think the Aussie sense of humour compares the Irish one? It's very similar, isn't it?
It's very similar because I think Australian people and Irish people have a lot in common. Yeah. Because over the centuries, you know, there was oppression there and there was colonies and things like that. And the only thing that, you know, that we could do that we didn't have to pay for was laugh. So we had a great ability to entertain each other.
You had to laugh.
You've had a fantastically varied career, from comedy to performing with Frank Sinatra. He called you his man in Europe.
Yeah.
How did it come about? What was he really like?
He was a lovely man. Was he popular here?
Yeah.
He was a lovely man, and he had a great affection for comedians. And he was when I did the show for him, I did it in a room not bigger than this studio. And his minders told me, you can't do this, you can't do that. I do a drunk act in my act. And they said, no way. Now, these guys were boozers. Sammy Davis Jr. And Frank Sinatra drank and smoked like fiends. So when I was sitting in front of them and I was told not to do it, I just launched into the drunk act. And these guys, it was like them looking into a mirror.
They would have loved it.
Looking at themselves. And they fell around the place laughing.
Yeah.
And that's how I met him.
Amazing.
And then he died.
I met
Sammy Davis, and he died.
Apparently, Dean Martin, who was renowned as the boozer, whose whole act revolved around being a boozer, his daughter said that he actually wasn't that big of a drinker. He often drank apple juice.
Yes, he certainly did. Well, he was. I didn't know him, obviously, but he was. He was very much. That was his act.
Yeah.
And it worked really, really well.
It did.
I think it, like, there was a guy called Foster Brooks.
Yeah.
And he did a drunk
brilliant.
Act.
Yeah.
That guy was a teetotaler.
Yeah.
My daughter's wedding, two daughters at their weddings, and I did this Father of the Bride speech as an act.
Yeah.
I couldn't do it at the wedding. I was drunk. If I had been sober, I could have done it perfect. but it's fun, you know, when you get stopped by a policeman in the car, you know, and he says, have you been drinking? I just had four pints of beer, half a bottle of vodka, and two bottles of gin. He said, are you serious? I said, of course I am. He said, here, blow into this. I said, why, do you not believe me? It's fun.
Now, someone else who you've also met is the late Maureen O'Hara.
Oh, Maureen, yes, she was a beautiful lady, and we were friends since her 80th birthday. Imagine that late in life. And she lived in Ireland, in the south west of Ireland, and her and I just met literally by accident. And we became dear friends, and I presented her with her birthday cake for 10 years running.
Aww.
Until she was 90. And we were friends up to very recently, and by golly, she was.
She was such a lovely actor.
Ah, she was a great, beautiful looking.
Gorgeous.
And a real, she was feisty.
Yeah, I bet.
She really was. You couldn't, she had a great sense of humour as well. And I got to kiss her. And she shared something with me that she shared with nobody else.
Share it with us.
There was a, well, at the end of the great movie, The Quiet Man, she and John Wayne were sitting on the back of the Aston cart, and there was a shot where she said something to him.
Yes.
And she hugged him, and it was off sound.
And no one knows what she said.
Nobody knows except me.
Oh, what did she say?
And?
I made her a promise I wouldn't.
Get away.
So you're going to have to follow me into the grave.
Well, you can see Brendan Grace live in action from November 12th until November 17th right across Australia. Head to tickettech.com.au for more info. Thank you so much for coming in.
The State Theatre here as well.
It's beautiful.
And it's great. I'm really looking forward to it now. Do I have to stand on my head?
No.
No.
It helps.